Okay, in this talk, we discuss the proof, if there is any, of consciousness. How do we know that consciousness exists? The simple answer is, well, consciousness is what we call it when you're awake. So as long as you're awake, as soon as you're awake, you're the evidence to yourself that consciousness exists. The fact that you know you're conscious is the evidence. But how do you test it? Arbitrarily. Yeah. So, for example, if I have this, yeah, and I know what the laws of nature should do to it, if I let it go, it falls. Yeah. Now, if I let it go, and imagine my hand is not there, and it does this, contrary or to what the laws of nature tells me should be doing, then I have to assume, yeah, that it's been moved artificially somehow, like there are more and more, it wasn't really moving the way it was projected to move, and it appeared in some respects to be moving artificially. Yeah, then that's how you know that there's some kind of consciousness involved, if it's contrary to what the laws of nature say, predict that it should be doing. That's how you know there's consciousness. So people who see ghosts, you see chairs turning, you can even see this floating and doing that. Then you're like, how is it generating thrust? If gravity is there, so you have to know that there's something artificial taking place. And you instinctively, intuitively deduce that there's a consciousness there. So now you have a ghost experience that people have documented, lots of ghost experiences. Even CCTV camera footage has recorded lots of ghost experiences. The ghosts are consciousnesses that don't have a body. So therefore, the existence of ghost phenomenon. Yeah, which there are some unresolved ghost mysteries out there. Like I said, you can go on YouTube and look at CCTV footage that's ca captured chairs moving as if somebody's sitting on it or somebody's moving it by itself. They could have rigged it, but if they prove that the camera footage wasn't played with, then that's an unexplained mystery. And there's loads of those about, which those type of mysteries prove that what we call consciousness happens in nature, yeah, and it happens without a body. It can happen without a body. Now, the significance of that means that if consciousness can happen without a body, therefore consciousness can exist before the physical universe. Yeah, another proof for the Almighty there. Yeah, so we're looking at the universe, we know gravity exists, so everything should be contracting. But it's expanding, pulling away from each other. Everything's pulling away from each other. How could that be? That's contrary to what we believe. That's like me dropping that, and instead of it doing that, it does that. Yeah? So have we just proven that there is consciousness in nature, or something equivalent to what we call consciousness? Or one, the reason I say equivalent is because if we try to prove consciousness arbitrarily without using yourself as an exact as evidence, if you try to prove it in other people, you have to look for things which contradict the way nature behave as proof of consciousness. Yeah. So it's a bit like if you do that, yeah, you expect it to spin, but if there's consciousness there, it can go against the laws of nature. So consciousness will go against all the laws of nature that we know. The expansion of the universe goes against all the laws of nature that we know. So have we just proved that there is consciousness in the universe, but now we're trying to attribute it to dark matter? Using the atheist argument, why does it have to be dark matter? Yeah, it doesn't have to be. It could be a natural consciousness. It could be the Almighty's consciousness for all we know. It could be that. Yeah. So why does it doesn't necessarily have to be dark matter, because when we say the beginning of the universe must have been choice, you tell us that it doesn't necessarily have to be choice. So we say the expansion of the universe, you say the expansion of the universe has to be dark matter, but we say it doesn't necessarily have to be dark matter. It could be consciousness like the one observed when you have ghost and apparition experiences. It could be that type of consciousness that's causing the expansion of the universe. Yeah, a universal consciousness, a consciousness that's all over the universe. Isn't that the Almighty? Isn't that omnipresence? It could be omnipresence that's causing that. Just think about it.